Right Honourable Speaker and Honourable Colleagues, I beg to move that the bill entitled the East African Crude Oil Pipeline Special Provisions Bill of 2021 be read the third time and do pass.
Today, Parliament passed the East African Crude Oil Pipeline Bill of 2021 to operationalize provisions of the host government agreement and some provisions of the intergovernmental agreement signed between Uganda and Tanzania to facilitate progress of the oil project.
Honourable members, I propose the question that the East African Crude Oil Pipeline Special Provisions Bill 2021 be read the third time and do pass. Those in favor say unto the contrary, nay. The ayes have it.
The bill under Clause 8 allows Uganda National Oil Company, UNOC, to pay oil transportation tariffs and other related services described in oil agreements with oil in kind instead of cash. Oil in kind has been listed at 15% of the crude oil.
We are proposing that payment in kind needs to be defined as to mean the use of crude oil as payment for transportation tariff and related services in accordance with the agreements for transportation of petroleum and the host government agreement. And the justification for that amendment is for clarity, because payment in kind has been used in some of the provisions of the bill.
We have a refinery which will be handling 60,000 barrels, and we have the rest going through this route, the pipeline.
The land rights of the project have been catered for, as the bill tagged acquisition of project land to requirements of Constitution and Land Acquisition Act of prior prompt and adequate compensation of the project affected persons. Affected persons whose land was valued and acquired before compensation have been provided with 15% annual interest rate.
This bill sets the bar much higher for compensation, much higher than our constitution, because under this bill, for anyone whom we valued and we've not paid, each and every year we'll be given 15% interest. So if we valued in 2018 and now we are paying in 2021, then it means we shall add you 45% of what you were supposed to earn in 2018.
There are issues in the law that related to the rights of citizens, especially the land clauses that were sticky until we moved an amendment to the proposed regime in the bill that we found acceptable, because then the movers were able to accept that we subordinate this bill the land laws of the land, which for me is acceptable and my team.
Another contentious provision was Clause 4 to give the bill supremacy over other laws other than the Constitution on the specific matters dealt with in the crude oil pipeline bill. However, Parliament compelled government to relax the jurisdiction of the supremacy to only existing laws relating to the matter under the Act.
We wanted this to strictly restrict itself on the laws concerning the oil sector, and not to extend to other laws which are outside. So because we didn't want to enact a law which is general and which was going to be abused, we wanted to enact a law which is specific and focusing strictly on the oil transportation.
Petroleum is an important asset to Ugandans, and first of all, it is a very new asset. So we are saying now that we have made the relevant laws connected with the pipeline which is for East Africa, because oil and petroleum will not start and end in Uganda. It is going across the cross borders. So we are saying that Ugandans should now be having an opening, should be having a regular framework that will help them to prepare and trade within the fuel framework that you have made.
Parliament is now left with amendments in the Public Finance Management Act of 2021 and the Income Tax Act to set off the petroleum industry. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.